Coming up on today's show.
I had migraines for several years. Okay. It started to get so severe that I was having migraines like every single day or like every other day. No medicines would work.
I had been diagnosed at about age 12 with ADD or ADHD. Along with that, I had something called restless leg syndrome.
All of that and more on today's show.
Hi, I'm Reverend Steve Millar, a minister here at Grace Cathedral, and this is my lovely wife, Kathy. On today's program, we have a young married couple joining us from Grace Cathedral, and they are going to share the love, the joy, the happiness it has brought them to serve the Lord at a young age.
We want to welcome you both to the program today. We're so happy to have you with us.
Thank you.
And speaking of being young, you just recently celebrated a wedding anniversary. Is that correct?
Yes.
And how long has it been?
2 years now.
2 years. Yeah. And how old were you when you first got married?
I was 18.
No, I was 20.
20. And where did you two meet?
So we were in the Sunday school when we first met. We were in class together.
At Grace Cathedral.
Yes, and we were in the oldest group for the Sunday school. And we just became friends, and I was friends with his sister, and we just started spending more time together, and then we started dating.
One thing led to another. You started dating and then got married. That's wonderful. So I know that you have two different stories as to how you came to Grace Cathedral. So Jonathan, why don't we start with you, and can you give us a little background?
So I was introduced in ministry. I was actually brought my mother's womb originally. My mom grew up in this ministry, and later on, they moved down to Virginia, and we would watch the program on TV. And then we started making trips up here. And the Lord would protect us all the time when we come up. I mean, there was times that, we were driving up here, and there was concrete barriers in either side of us. And we were just trying to get up here to get to church. And it was just rain. It was pouring. And then half our windshield wipers broke. So the driver's side kept going, but the passenger side just stopped. It wouldn't go at all. Later on, we found, the arm for the windshield wipers had snapped. The driver's side shouldn't have even kept running, but the Lord allowed it to keep running so we can get here safely, because there was nowhere for us to pull off.
Right.
I mean, it was concrete barriers either side, construction, got people behind us, it was raining.
And I bet your mother was praying the whole time.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah.
I mean, there was...
How long is that drive, Jonathan?
That drive, it would take us anywhere between 10 to 12 hours.
And that was the main purpose you were coming?
You're right. Yeah, we were coming up here to come to church. I mean, there was other times too. Like, I remember we were driving up here, and we were getting to one of those toll booths, and we were on the side where there was a concrete barrier to the left of us, and the semi just started merging over into our lane, and the trailer's going to take us out. The Lord prevented us from being hit, but he almost hit us. I mean, there was nowhere for us to go. I mean, we couldn't turn right because there's the trail. We couldn't turn left because there was a concrete barrier. And we just kept on visiting. Lord, I mean, there was tons of stories like that where he would just protect us.
So what was it like, though, traveling up, knowing that you were coming to church and spending the weekend at church? Were you excited?
We were excited. We were very excited coming up. I mean, we couldn't wait to come back the next time. I mean, it was always sad when we would leave to go back down home at the time. So, yeah, it was awesome when we moved up here.
Yeah, I remember your mother when she was younger. We had a junior orchestra, and she was in it. She played the flute.
Right.
And she loves music, and she's very musical.
Yes.
And she brought her kids up loving music and playing music.
Right.
Because all of you are kind of involved in music in one shape or form.
Right.
And one of those music groups is a handbell choir. Mm-hmm. And what else do you do, Jonathan? You play other instruments as well, right?
I play the guitar in the country gospel band. I sing in the Jubilee Youth Choir. I even help out with the audio booth.
That's wonderful. You have many talents. And now, Victoria, what about you? What's your story in coming to Grace Cathedral?
So when I was younger, my family had come to church before, and they had brought us a couple times. And so they knew about church. We just weren't attending at the time. And so later on, something happens in our family, and they realized it was time for us to come back to church and to start getting ready for, because they knew that the rapture was going to happen. And they were giving us our opportunity for my sister and I to come and get saved and receive the Holy Ghost.
And about how old were you at that time?
So about 12, 13. Uh-huh. Yeah. And so when we got up here, it was unlike any church I'd ever been to before. I'd been to many churches with different family members, but my mom, she would adamantly not take us to other churches. She knew that this was the truth, and she would only let us read the King James Bible. She knew that this is where God was. And
so you came in, and you probably went into Sunday school.
Yes. So we actually, our first service was the July 4th camp meeting. And so we were in those services, and then we went up to the Sunday school, and that's where I met Jonathan. And it was, the Sunday school teachers there had so much love for me, because they have verses that they would recite for, like, as a homework assignment almost. And they asked each child, you know, what's the verse? And they asked me, do you know any verses to say? And I told them, I was like, I'm sorry, I don't. And they're like, well, you know, John 3:16. And I did it the best I could. And they actually gave me one of Reverend's Armageddon books, and they gave it to me, and they said, you know, this is from the Sunday school, you know, be blessed with it, and, you know, use it for, you know, getting ready for the rapture.
So what happened when you read the book Armageddon?
I didn't know really anything about the rapture. I was never taught that. I was always taught, you know, you just live your life as normal, and, you know,
just to clarify, just for our audience, the rapture is a second coming of Jesus Christ.
Yeah, and I had no knowledge of that beforehand. And so it was really shocking to me to read it and to see. And I was like, how did I miss, you know, half the Bible, you know, because he has scriptures in that book. And I would just read through, and I would just be shocked and just excited that I would be able to go in the rapture.
Mm-hmm. And many people don't know about the Battle of Armageddon and what's going to take place in the tribulation period. And a lot of what Reverend writes about in that book is very shocking. Mm-hmm. And I think if people would read that book, it would shake them up and make them realize they need to get right with God and they need to be ready for the rapture, because believe me, you do not want to be left behind in the tribulation period, because it's going to be horrible.
Yeah.
Yes. Armageddon and the rapture book both will give you the reality that Jesus is coming back.
Yeah. And it was such a help to me too, because I was still such a, you know, I was brand new to being Christian, like
you
a real Christian.
Did you know the born again experience? Did you know about that?
I didn't know about the Holy Ghost baptism. I mean, the only thing I knew about was you get, you know, baptized when you're a baby, and that's all we were taught is, you know, once you do that, you're a part of the church, and maybe you get confirmed, but that's all I knew was just live your life and do what you need to do and
do the best you can.
Do the best you can, pretty much.
So this was a whole new world for you. And what a service to come in on was 4th of July camp meeting with all the music and singing and people coming in from different states. And I'm sure you were probably there as well, but you didn't know each other at the time.
Right.
But just think, if the Lord wouldn't have brought you here to Grace Cathedral, you might never have met your husband.
So Victoria, when you were at camp meeting and you saw the people singing up on stage, what did you think about them?
I really loved the music here, because I had been used to music where it's just kind of the same thing. It talks about the same stuff. And this music here actually had you know, substance to it. It actually had meaning to it. And that it shocked me that, you know, it was all written here. And that, you know, our singers and musicians, they had the love to, you know, sacrifice their time and energy to, you know, sing for the church, you know, and sing for the Lord and, you know, be a blessing right. to people.
And little did you know that eventually you would become a part of one of the groups and you're in the bell choir.
Yes.
And we need to take a quick break right now, but we're going to talk about you being in those groups, both of you using your talents for the Lord. And we have a special treat. We're going to be showing one of your songs that you both perform in together. So friends, stay with us. You're not going to want to miss this performance. We'll be right back.
I knew absolutely nothing about music. I couldn't sing. I didn't even have the talent to sing at that point in time. Since then, the Lord has helped bless me with like rhythm. I can now hear different notes.
Patchy rain will arrive in the north later in the day. On FM, on long wave, on digital radio, and online.
It's 10 o'clock, and this is The World with Ritala Shah.
At Thomas Point Light, the air temperature was 60 degrees. The winds were from the east at 13 knots. The water temperature was 58 degrees.
Already 7 miles away from the Kennedy Space Center at an altitude of 5 miles.
10-4-3-3-M, Eastern Daylight Time.
Correction north of Florida Boulevard at four-wheel auto parts, 1062-RD936.
Welcome back, and if you're just joining us, we have Jonathan and Victoria with us, and we were just talking about the talents that the Lord has given them that they are using to bless the kingdom. And I want to ask you, when you both started in the bell choir, were you both saved and filled with the Holy Ghost?
Yes.
And that's very important.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Because music, it needs to go forth with that anointing. Mm-hmm. And if you're not saved and filled with the Holy Ghost, that anointing's not going to go forth.
Yeah.
And so what was it like starting in the bell choir? I know you started off very early. Mm-hmm. What group were you first in?
I was actually in your group in Angel Chimes when I first started. You do a really good job of teaching.
Oh, thanks.
You're welcome.
I know I drill a lot.
And,
speaking of which, you started Victoria in the boot camp,
yes.
right? And what happened was
That's
you
the
came.
Bell boot camp.
Yes, the okay. Bell Boot Camp, and we have different levels of mm-hmm. training. We have the Jesus Joy Bells, which is the colored bells for the younger kids, and then they graduate into the mm-hmm. Angel Chime group, and then from there it was the Heavenly Bells group, which you ended up graduating into.
Right.
And then when you came in, you really needed to be in the Heavenly Bell group, but they were already playing probably level 2 and level 3 music. Mm-hmm. So you really needed to learn quickly.
Yes.
So we put together a boot camp to really, you know, drill you on how to get ahead so that you can move into that group. What did you think about that boot camp?
Honestly, it was really fun. And I had never really known about handbells before. And you know, we have different techniques that we do to make different sounds with the bells, and there's a lot of stuff, different
yes.
stuff you can do. I mean, different ways that you ring can affect the sound. And it really was like a crash course.
It was.
But you taught everything. I mean, we learned everything we really needed for the basics. I mean, even down to note values, you know, how long we hold a note out for.
Could you read music at the time?
I had a little bit of music knowledge beforehand. Okay. I had played an instrument before, but I couldn't really remember a lot of it. So like I knew how long a note was held out for, but I couldn't really read what note was where and, you know, sharps and different things like that. So it really, it helped me a lot when you taught me.
I think people don't realize that, you know, the small bell groups, I don't know what their age is, but you start teaching them how to read music at a very young age.
Yes, a very young age. And then when they get into those other groups, Carrie DeFranco is the director of the adult groups, and it's just amazing how advanced that music is and what you guys are able to play and perform.
Yes.
And actually, we have a song that we're going to show now, and Carrie DeFranco is in that song as well. She's actually performing, and it's "Must Jesus Bear the Cross Alone." And it's such a beautiful, beautiful song. So we're gonna go ahead and take a look at that now. So friend, watch and enjoy.
Thank you.
That was such a beautiful song. And I think it's so wonderful that you both are in the group together, playing together. And you also are in the Jubilees, a singing group for the youth. And Johnny, can you share with us how the Lord has increased your talents?
Yes, you can. Yeah, Maria, the leader of the group, had asked me to join. And so I tried out for her. And at that time, I was about 13 years old. I knew absolutely nothing about music. I couldn't sing. I didn't even have the talent to sing at that point in time. So much so, one of the leaders of the group that was working with me even thought I was tone deaf at one point. And since then, the Lord has helped bless me with like rhythm. I can now hear different notes. I mean, he even gave me a voice to sing. I mean, I didn't sound good at all.
And you have a solo now on one of the songs.
Yeah. Yeah, the Lord blessed and he moved and I got to get to sing with a great group of people, which is awesome.
And you both get to sing together in that group as well. Mm-hmm. And I think that's very special when married couples can do the work of the Lord together.
Right.
And make beautiful music for the Lord. Now, do you want to share some miracles and healings that you've received through Grace Cathedral?
Yeah. When I was younger, I was actually, I had migraines. I had them really bad. So much so that I would even get stroke-like symptoms. Like, I remember once I was playing in the backyard, and just all of a sudden out of the blue, it started from my fingertips going up my arm. I started feeling numb. Just on my, I think it was my left side. And so much so it started going up my body and even the left side of my face started getting numb, even to the point where half my tongue on the left side was getting numb. And at that point in time, I was having migraines quite a bit. And my mom figured that a migraine was coming. She kept asking me if I was starting to have a headache. And I kept saying no. And we went to the hospital just because the symptoms were so severe. And sure enough, I started to get a migraine. It even would get so bad, I would be studying, doing my schoolwork, and I would start getting black spots in my vision, and I couldn't see my paper that I was trying to read to do my schoolwork. So much so, and this stuff would happen before the migraine would come. Just like symptoms that would happen.
Before. And that would have been scary.
Yeah, did this happen a long time? I mean, over a period of 6 months or something? Or?
I had migraines for several years.
Okay.
It started to get so severe that I was having migraines like every single day or like every other day. And I mean, when I would get a migraine, if I wasn't able to take medicine beforehand, it would just be too out of control. I mean, no medicines would work. At all, I would sleep 12 to 16 hours to get rid of it. I mean, for a migraine, you can't have light, you can't have sound. Mm-hmm. It was just bondage.
And you were just a teenager then during that time.
For sure. And I got prayer by Reverend, and the Lord just took them all away instantly. And I haven't had a migraine since, and it's been years now.
That's fantastic. When you're playing music, it's very hard to concentrate if you have a headache. So the Lord really did move for you.
I mean, there's no way. I mean, if I was getting migraines every day, there's no way I could function properly, even work. I mean, play music. I mean, anything.
Wow.
It's bondage.
Now, Victoria, did you receive any miracles?
Yeah, actually, the first time I got prayer when we came to church, I had been diagnosed at about age 12 with ADD or ADHD. And I had the hyperactive type where I had trouble focusing. I had a problem with my memory. I would, go throughout my day and I would put something down and forget about it completely. And it would really affect my schoolwork. I would be, trying to focus on my studies, but my mind would just wander and I couldn't focus at all. And I couldn't sit still for long periods of time. And along with that, I had something called restless leg syndrome, where you get the urge to stretch your legs out and it's almost painful. You get it so often. Mm-hmm. And I would have to drink, lots of things with like electrolytes in them to try and help my body, relax a little bit. I would take medicine that would make me feel very nauseous and very tired. I would sleep for a couple hours every day. And then I came and I went to the invalid section, and Reverend Mockimer prayed for me. And that was the first miracle I got. I've been able to focus a lot better and just stay still. I'm able to focus, and it's really been a blessing.
Oh, that's amazing. There's power in prayer. Mm-hmm. I don't think people mm-hmm. realize how powerful prayer is, and that you can receive a miracle and healing for any condition. And sometimes it is instant.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Well, you know, what a blessing, you know, that you guys have told us about miracles, healings. But friend, we want you to stay with us, because we'll be right back in a few.
Second Corinthians 6:17. Wherefore come out from among them, and be ye separate, saith the Lord, and touch not the unclean thing, and I will receive you. Frank from Cuyahoga Falls, Ohio shares this testimony. I had really bad headaches, and the pain went all along the side of my neck and across my forehead. I received prayer from Reverend Angley, and through the gift of discernment, the Lord let him know I had pressure on my brain. I have not been bothered with that since. Our Grace family is supported by viewers like you. Your donation is greatly appreciated. Your financial gift ensures that this faith-building program can continue to be a blessing to you and your family, and to many others just like you.
Welcome back, and friend, we hoped you enjoyed the program today. I know we did. And we want to thank you, Jonathan and Victoria, for being on the program today and for sharing your stories with us.
And they received some wonderful miracles. And friend, the greatest miracle of all is the miracle of salvation. And I'd like to give you this opportunity right now to receive Jesus Christ into your heart. Pray with me and say, "Oh God, save my soul. Forgive me for my sins, but I have come home to serve you the rest of my life. Come into my heart, Jesus. Come on in, Jesus." Friend, if you meant that prayer, you have Jesus Christ in your heart, come and visit us in the services, and I know that you'll be blessed in a great way.
We'll see you next time. God bless. Bye-bye.
If you are encouraged or blessed by today's program, let us know. We would love to hear from you. You can email us at ourgracefamily@thegracecathedral.org or write to us. Get caught up on all the episodes of Our Grace Family on the Grace Cathedral YouTube channel. If you're blessed by what you see, be sure to share it with others. And remember to subscribe to be notified for the latest episodes. If you are encouraged by what you heard on today's show, let us know by sending us a message on our Facebook page. And come visit us at Grace Cathedral and worship the Lord with us. This program has been made possible by the friends and partners of Ernest Angley Ministries.